just find no one there. You can push into lower B and kind of backstep into long, perhaps. That's the kind of stuff I like to call. I don't like to run a normal rifle setup. I think it's really weak, especially on Dust 2, where you can get the Glocks are so powerful and they can just move so fastly and get onto bomb side so quickly. I like to get the first pick and fall back, and it looks like something interesting might be happening here. Definitely not a standard rifle setup here.
And look at the grenades they have. This is really big. 4 HE grenades and 2 smokes and flashbangs as well. They're up on short. Great grenade comes in. Now it's going to be a follow-up right there. They actually stopped for it, and they could have been all killed if they had kept pushing there. Fnatic, really good presence of mind. Now they have a 2-man lead. Existence, landing shot through here, not going to kill anyone at all. And this is a very, very nice start for the Swedish team.
Absolutely, that's 2 massive kills, especially from Olaf Meister. That first shot he got onto MBK really set the tone for the round, and Scream actually answering back on a kill to Crims. That's a big scalp to take down, and he's going to be looking to stay alive there. He's the only player left in B bomb site, and we're going to see the CTs kind of split apart here. They've been pulled apart, and they're going to be looking just to kind of find out where that bomb is and then kind of rotate to where the action is.
Yeah, Existence has to pick up some great kills here, but he's already been spotted. Now it's tricky, not going to hit the headshot. It's almost a requirement at that range, just have the instant headshots like Kenny's been up to here. Gets the one on, and he's going to get Pronex as well. No! Pronex survived on exactly 1 point of health, and now it's a 1-on-3 here. Scream in the middle, making noise. Flusher is going to execute him. If he had got that kill down on long, they would have had the bomb, and it would have been a very, very different round. But that's it. Fnatic pick up the pistol, and Henry, it's the return of the scouts.
It makes you feel a little bit sick when I see them being bought. I'm not really sure why. I'm really not a fan of this. I guess on Dust 2 it makes a little bit more sense because you can kind of face middle together, and the T's will be trying to get gap shots almost. So look, you can see the T there looking to get any gap shots he can, but unless you get the kill there, the scout automatically, for me, this becomes, oh God, why do we buy that? We haven't got a kill from it. And I think they'll have to do some serious work now to make those be worth their money.
It's also interesting that it's Scream and Kenny who's picked them up. I mean, especially when Smith has body armor, so they could, if they, I would definitely give one of them to Smith with that body armor, and then Scream can have the C set. That makes a lot more sense to me. Down the middle here, Scream's gonna be spotting a couple of people, and they're trying to.
As smoke comes down, it kind of automatically makes it a bad purchase for me.
Yeah. No dice,
oh,
actually.
God, there we go.
Kenny picks up the scout kill there, no body shot happening. But they're just jumping and shooting in the middle. That's what you can do with the scout. That's actually one of the reasons why it's really effective. Not going to hit the shot through either, and now Fnatic decide, well, actually, if we wait forever for these scouts to hit us, we're pretty going to lose the round, so why not just go for the long push, which is what they're doing. And Kenny and Scream, they're stacked up here, but they're not getting any shots through.
Oh, nice work.
5-on-3 now, they keep pushing on. Flush is going to be able to kill NBK. There's the D coming out straight, headshot onto Flusher. It's a 2-on-4, and now they're up in the sights. Smith is going to pick up the kill. Pronax now in a 1-on-4. Hasn't got the bomb plant, probably won't get the bomb plant, and Titan bring it directly back. NBK with a double Deagle headshot, and then it's going to be a round. It's not even the scout so much as it was the Deagle.
Yeah, well, it was fantastic work from Titan there, like kind of showing me that the scout can be viable. I guess it does kind of make sense when they can do those jumping shots and kind of surprise terrorists when they think they're safe, and kind of they don't expect people to be able to jump over smoke and kill them. So that was a great opening from Kenny Esther.
Did Fnatic hesitate too much once they saw those scouts?
Once that kill came in, I think when Kenny Esther got that opening frag, that's when they kind of started questioning the whole round and kind of maybe overcooked it a little bit. But that's going to be a great comeback into the game for Titan. As you can see here, Kenny should be able to clean up here, and he does, and that's going to leave Flusher in a very tricky situation indeed.
4 kills just like that, and if Kenny had gone down, it would have been a really good round for Fnatic all of a sudden. But now, bombs dropped in the middle, and Kenny should be able to stay safe inside that CT spawn. But Flusher just trying to jump around here, see if he can pick up some random person in a corner. But with a Glock, it's really not that likely. So 2-1 here, I mean, the impact of winning this second round is going to be felt all throughout this first half, I think.
Yeah, definitely. That is going to definitely shake up the terrorists a little bit after winning such a big round on the pistol. To lose it like they did, it's going to be very frustrating for them. And Titan not making the same mistake. They managed to win their anti-eco, and I think we'll have to see a full eco here from the terrorists. JW has got enough money to kind of potentially force something here, and we'll see what they can opt to do. CZ's coming out.
Oh, when they're hesitating like that to buy, do you think that's a point in time when they're discussing it? They're thinking, oh, maybe we should?
Yeah,
but Titan,
I think they made the right decision there.
Look at this, this is interesting. Oh, just going kind of aggressively. Grim's caught wondering about how this all turned up this way, and Existence going to get another kill in before he finally goes down, and Kenny has exchanged the scout for something much more effective. It's the AWP, and Flusher is going to get the kill right there. The 1-on-3 now happening, and Yeah, that's it.
I think that's great, though. I think that's just showing that they're not going to be playing defensive this game. They're going to be running on middle every opportunity they get and going to be taking those first frags. I think that's definitely the way to approach CT. You don't want to be waiting on kind of hiding on the bomb sites. You want to be kind of getting those first frags. And here we go. Now we can see Titan have opted for that setup we wanted to see, the kind of dual setup. It kind of makes the team able to flow very nicely on the map and kind of adapt to wherever the terrorists seem to be aiming to go.
Are they going to take the peak middle? Because JW is looking there. He's actually down on the low ground as well. He's going to peek right this second and he misses the shot. At least he doesn't go down, but he spots at least one and pretty hurt me even two orbs. So I think they know right now what the deal is if they didn't already. I think almost every team is going to expect Titan to do this. So it's not going to be a big surprise for Fnatic. Now the question is if they can find a way to zone these orbs out, use the smokes, use the flashbangs correctly, and get up close and take them down. NBK with a good opening onto Olofmeister. And that's one of the key players on Fnatic, so not exactly the best start here. They've lost one rifle. Plenty of time to see if they can pick up a kill, and with the, you know, with this AWP on JW, that's one of the ways they can use on the terrorist side, is just look for an opening.
Here we go. Time ticking away. The smoke, nice smoke from NBK. That's going to be like, it's going to slow him down for another, at least another 20 seconds. Terrorists seem to be kind of committed toward that long area. We can see
this could be a slaughter right here, Henry. I mean, we could, this is NBK the execution and just waiting. I mean, he's already got the name for it.
Oh, look at that, another smoke going in there. It's going to be really frustrating for Fnatic here. I think they've got to have to call it out there and go somewhere else. That's I think a wise decision before that got really messy.
I'm wondering if they could feel like, you know, death right around
the corner. Yeah, you could smell him outside those doors perhaps, but here we go. Kenny has great pick on the Peronex there. That's going to tie up this round, I believe. Not enough time to really execute anywhere else. And we can see Kenny is trying to make some more leeway onto the bomb side there, but it looks like with 10 seconds left, this round will be going in favor of Team Titan.
Yeah, and I'm really worried here. JW is running far away. Frusher wants to put the bomb down, not going to be able to. And JW has to stay alive here. Once the time runs out, he will. Really important note, of course, if you die on the terrorist side after the time has run out, you don't get any money for
zero
losing.
Cash.
But he gets to save the AWP, so it's all right. It's actually really good in the end, because that's a lot of money on him right here. But that's 4-1, and a quick reminder again that Titan are on the less favored side.
Exactly, but this is why they choose it, because people expect to win rounds as T, and I think it's almost a mind game. If you start losing like this, it's very frustrating. It's hard to get back into it. I think they've kind of found this perfect formula of the dual orb setup that is almost impossible to like penetrate, it seems like. I've seen a lot of teams struggle against this standard setup, and it seems a lot more teams in Europe are actually starting to adopt this method as well.
Yeah, Smith's going to take down JW. That's the one orb they saved, gone already. So this isn't even Kenny, it's Smith's, but on this map, Smith's is somehow just a much better open than he is on any other map.
He can be just as handy as Kenny S, I think. Like, yeah. Especially when he gets, he's more of a defensive style AWP. He's not the kind of guy jumping around and kind of doing all the flick shots. He kind of just hits the shots that matter, and I think that's why he's so valuable on this map.
I definitely agree. Now, another round where Fnatic start off being a man down, and are they going to be able to do something about it? They're sort of slowly creeping up towards short and down on long. The bomb is actually going to be picked up by Olofmeister any second, but they still have to figure out a way to deal with Kenny down there, and they don't have any more smokes left, so what are they going to do?
Not really sure. It looks like it's going from bad for worse than them here. They're just about to make their way out middle, potentially a little split there, and they get caught up with the Molotov, and it looks like they're kind of just lying in wait and kind of just waiting to lose this round, perhaps. The kind of smoke's going down. Ooh. That's probably the best smoke they could have possibly done there. Kenny S being pushed back onto the bomb site. It looks like this first pick to be very important indeed. Scream taking out Pronax. Kenny S taking out Cribs. And it's huge work from him. He's taking out Olofmeister. Will he be able to make it a third for him?
Absolutely picked apart at the moment here. Kenny missing a bunch of no scopes, but MBK is going to take him down. That was still a really nice sequence, and Kenny's at a ridiculous 12-0-1 here. Absolutely carrying Titan on this map at the moment. And even worse still, that's a couple of rounds without a bomb plant for Titan. They are going to have to eco, or sorry, for Fnatic, they're going to have to eco right now.
Absolutely.
They are not in a good position anymore. And I mean, I don't know, this has been a rollercoaster ride of emotion for both teams. It has to have been. But right now, Titan are on the incline.
It looks so strong right now. I just don't see how you can knock out this kind of setup. It's just, it just works so well for them. I think if I had to suggest something on what they can do to get back into this, I think they're going to have to play a little bit more traditional. As I always say, I think they need to opt for more of the B splits, kind of smoking off key areas and kind of taking it as a team. Going for like the four people out middle, one person in the tunnel perhaps, and kind of just trying to get into positions where the orbs won't be able to take precedence.
Yeah, bit of a B-split push, which obviously we're big fans of here. Yep. Good round coming out. Kenny does die finally, so that's good news in a sense. But the bad news is Titan also have, you know, just more money than they should have.
Yeah, definitely. Well, it allows them to kind of play, adopt a more flamboyant playstyle, as it were. They can get away with more things. They know there's money there, so they can kind of take the big risks, do the big boosts, and kind of maybe face middle a little bit more, as I think you can see someone actually might be going for. Oh, not going to have enough angle to kind of face JW there, but here we can see the terrorists taking a more fast approach here, and this is looking good. They managed to get the first pick.
Oh, great headshot in return, though. Krim's really taking out MBK, so it should have been a big opening, but now by the car here, actually shooting through as well and hitting that shot. And down in pit, still two people waiting. Flusher coming up from short's gonna go down to Smith's, and Existence will finally go down, but it's Smith's with the double, looking for a triple, seeing he can one-up himself here. Not gonna get the flick quite yet, but now they've got them locked down. JW will respond to that kind of aggression, and it's gonna be a 2-on-2. Krims is gonna spray down Kenny, and that looks like a really weird position from our point of view. Now Scream, in a 1-on-2 here, and they have so much time to work with Fnatic.
Yeah, this is why they're not going to be forced to do anything here. They can just work out where Scream is and then kind of adapt their playstyle. The best thing I think they could do here is kind of just keep JW down that long area with the AWP, kind of covering Krims as he goes up with the bomb. I think that's definitely the smarter move to make. That will kind of force Scream to kind of, even if he makes one kill, he has to kind of take out Scream as well. But so much time on the board, it's just going to be... Scream's going to be questioning himself as to where the T's are going right now.
You're up against what's basically a robot headshot machine, so you've got to be really careful. If they don't peek him exactly at the same time, he could kill both of them in a second. There it is, and oh my god! Scream sprays down, headshot on Krims, and JW falls, and a big opportunity thrown right down the bin. That's a big problem here now, because, I mean, Fnatic, they knew just as much as we did how much they probably should have won that round.
Yeah, and Scream seems so certain that they weren't going to move. Like, he just seems so locked on. He seems so ready for that round. And it's a really fantastic play from him, and that's really going to frustrate Fnatic. And we can see here, we just look at the setup now Titan. What the hell is going on? What a strong setup this is going to be. It's going to be almost impossible to stop them now.
Yeah, this is some really, really dirty Counter-Strike. Titan are going for the win here. Nothing about honor or anything else. We're talking auto-snipers and AWPs, and actually, they right now just trading, and a great grenade's gonna take down Existence, so this purchase is not at all paying off for the Titan team, and actually could come back to bite them quite severely. Yeah. They've just spent a lot of money on this, and they might have to pay for it. Scream goes down now, auto-sniper and AWP, and actually want them, yeah, they should definitely fall back. This investment, like, there's 14,200 value on them right now, just between the two of them.
That's pretty insane, isn't it? They really do want to save those guns if they're going to... Well, to be fair, like, that round obviously was a big risk for them. They wanted to show, like I said, they want to show that they're going to adopt that flamboyant play style. But I think it might have been a stretch too far, like taking three sniper rifles and Dust 2, although as exciting as it is to watch, it really is difficult to retake bomb sides, especially if you're not getting the opening frags. That's going to get Fnatic another round on the board, and hopefully they'll want to string some together now. I think they've worked out how they can get the opening frags at a round. Taking when they get that long spawn, they saw that they seem to be getting that opening frag. So it'll be interesting to see what they do from now on. I'd like to see them do some more set pieces and kind of lock out the orbs almost with the smoke grenades.
Yeah, very good round. Flush will pick up the double kill, and it's it's now or never for Fnatic. Seven rounds is actually already a little bit too much, I think, for Titan on the CT side. So Fnatic, yeah. And even more importantly, now that they finally break the loss streak, they got to keep winning. The worst thing that can happen is go back to a loss here. Auto Sniper and AW here still in play, and the rest of Titan can buy up. And I think even losing this next round, they could probably still buy once more. And down on long, they are Kenny scoped up here. If they try and jump into pit, he might be fast enough to do this.
Oh, he is. You know he is. Oh, as I say that, he's not. Unfortunately, not been able to land that shot. But here we go. They've got control of that long area now. Kenny is still facing there. He fancies the chance of getting this headshot.
Yeah, down middle, they have Scream really close to the doors, trying to keep an ear on what's happening there. But I like the idea if they can keep Olofmeister down in the pit and just wait until maybe Titan get a little bit anxious and go and repeat the long area. That could be dangerous. What are they doing? They're on short, they're on long, and they got one guy in upper duck. I'm just wondering if this is going to end up being a B push after, if they can get a pick off on somebody.
I think this might be a split, perhaps. When you've got that control of long, it's great to pincer at the A-bomb side, so they might be looking what they want to do. Like, it's hard for the CT to control both areas, short and long. They're going to have to possibly opt to just control one of these now. Look, this is where they start getting pulled apart.
Oh, Existence with an interesting flash, but it feels like Titan were really out of this round to begin with. Especially when MBK ran down like that with a knife and a grenade out, that did not look like a good idea at all. And what's even worse is that Titan actually had the setup to deal with that short push that was coming in. Because they had Existence in the background. He could have flashed his way into short and it could have been a very different engagement.
I think that he's needed to do it a bit sooner. As soon as you lose control of that long area, you need to kind of take control of somewhere else. Either you push B tunnels and work out where the T's are going, or you completely lock down that short area so they can't pincer you like that was. You just saw MBK there kind of like looking in both areas, trying to do anything he could to kind of like make sure he wasn't getting backstabbed. So I think Fnatic could potentially benefit from doing that more, just getting control of one area of the map. That's what's so key on Dust 2, is taking what area and precedence in one area, and then kind of leaving someone there, and then going to take another. And then you can kind of pull the CTs apart bit by bit until they kind of crumble like they did there.
Olaf Meister right now with 1, 2, and 7, definitely far from his absolutely, you know, really, really great performance on Inferno. So that's obviously a problem, but at least Fnatic are starting to win rounds here. They've built up some money on their side so they can lose a round or two and actually still buy, and that's a big deal. But Titan, they keep saving a lot of rifles, so they're gonna, you know, they don't have to eco either. They can just keep buying, and the entry frag is gone. Fnatic's way a couple of times, this time missing the shot here. MBK still plenty of health, gonna be a Molotov followed up. Flusher in a really bad corner, gonna have to stay alive, gets the spray through, almost takes down Kenny, but it is not enough. And in the middle, they're gonna be rushing out, so Flusher is just a distraction. Smith will pick up an instant headshot, taking down JW. A very aggressive round coming up from the Swedish team. They want to bounce back and see if they can reclaim this game for themselves, but Smith with an insane flashbang is going to take down Pronax, and now Crims in the middle finally returning. But is it too late, Henry?
Oh, I'm not sure. I think this round is going in favor of Titan. I think the next round is going to decide it. Oh god, and Kenny S has got different ideas about that. Takes out Scream himself and does Fnatic a favor, and perhaps got him right back into this round.
I'm not sure if he didn't just save Flusher. He was on 15 HP. He would have maybe gone down, and actually Titan, if we bring up the scoreboard really quickly, can we see how much money they have? Yeah, if they lose these, everyone else can buy except these two, so they actually might have to save. I definitely counsel for saving at this point. That was probably not supposed to be Fnatic round, I think.
Definitely not. I think there was a bit of confusion and a bit of lack of communication as to where the positions of the CTs were there. Kenny S kind of taking that attention.
You know what it is?
What's that?
It's karma for buying an auto sniper in the first place. That's what it's down to.
That'll teach them.
Oh, Fnatic, I mean, they're still going to be really far behind. 7-4 is not a comfortable position, but they keep winning rounds, and Titan keep making maybe a few mistakes, a few slip-ups here and there, and that's all Fnatic needs to bring it back home. So we'll have to see if they can keep it up. 12th round coming up, and they're going to be rebuying on the Titan side, but now I think their bank is really running dry as well. I mean, they can't keep losing and just saving a couple of rifles here. Now they need to start winning again.
Yeah, they need to get some more rounds on the board. They've had such a fantastic campaign so far, but as you say, it seems like rounds seem to be slipping away from them now. A few silly mistakes here and there, but it looks like they'll be going back to this full formation. They managed to save the guns last round, so hopefully they'll be able to kind of mix it up a little bit now, which it looks like they are. Kenny S will be looking for this first pick here. Anyway, he can. This might be it, and he's unable to land the shot there. He'll have to fall back, and MBK actually picked up a nice frag of himself.
I think Pronax thought he was down in the pit, because I think he must have heard him jumping by, so very sneaky play coming up from MBK.
Position.
And good flashbang in, Kenny S. Ooh. Actually still up there, goes for the peak, and instant headshot. JW, not really sure he got that. Now down on long, they got to be really careful here, because Existence is scoped up with an auto sniper, and if they just push for it, that could really be bad for them. They're going to go back down middle, but that's another trap setup right here. So Fnatic, I mean, they have the 4-on-4, probably have the advantage overall, but they need to find the right way of executing. And there's a JW with a really great opening inside the bombsite. Scream has to come up really big. Auto sniper down the middle, not really doing too much for Existence right now. Actually, MBK is going to pick up JW coming all the way from behind. Scream, one kill here could be absolutely golden right now. And time is running out as well. Scream, and that's MBK again from behind. Scream picks up Crims, and Flusher is going to go down, and Scream will do it once more. Titan, after losing a bunch of rounds, all 4 rounds in a row, they finally bring it back here. And that's obviously very important for the French-Belgian team.
Absolutely.
Fnatic can still buy, but this is an interesting turn of events right now. I really don't know what to make of it.
Yeah, well, especially with JW and no AWP in hand now, I think they're going to have to either run something much faster or kind of try and, well, look, actually saying that, looks like we can see three terrorists heading over towards that B area. Will they opt for a rush? No, they won't. They're going to slow down with that smoke grenade. Pronax actually getting himself in a very interesting position right now. What can he make of this?
He's right here, the edge of the smoke. They are gunning through. He's going to be walking out, and there's an auto sniper waiting, chucked right down. And then it's going to be Scream alone over here in the B bomb site. Now would be an absolutely prime time. Once this Molotov is gone, if they can push and take the bomb site, that's going to be once again fantastic. But he spotted everyone. Scream is on the radio right now, calling for backup. There's the one grenade. He peeks up, nice. Gets the one. Can we get a double kill? He's going to go for it, but he goes down, and Kenny will pick up one right through the door. Zolofmeister is gone. If they make this crossover, they got to be careful. Kenny almost. No scoping, flush it out through the door, but it's a 2-on-4 hold, and Henry, as good as they are, I'm not sure this is enough to hold this bomb site.
It's really not looking. See the low HP there on Flusher. He's going to do really well if they're going to clutch this round. 4-on-2 against a team as strong as Tidal. I think it's a stretch too far. JW is going to do all he can, though. He manages to take down Kenny S. If he can make this frag, it might be a chance here. Oh, MVK makes sure that's not going to happen, though. So that's going to be the 9th round here in favor of Titan. I think that is actually going to have to push Fnatic onto Anikia. Let's just see as this ticks over what they will have left.
I think they have a little bit.
Let's see. Okay, we can see a few drops there being coming in. We've got Crims on $8,000 there, so should be fine for money. They should be fine for the rest of the game. In fact, it looks like they racked up a couple of big rounds there.
No, I mean right now it's Crims and Flusher, and JW and Pronax are keeping up. But Olofmeister has sort of almost exited the game at this point.
Dropped off here, hasn't he? After such a big performance in Inferno, he's gone 1-for-9 here on the T side of Dust2, which is normally the big. It's a deathmatch map, really. You kind of expect your big fraggers to kind of getting the entry kills and kind of showing their aim off. But
maybe he did. But I mean, just spend everything he had that round. Kenny's going to miss this shot again. This time he falls back. He doesn't want to re-peek after what happened last time.
I think that's a very wise decision from him.
Playing it safe. Here and every round from here on out. 9-6, that's an absolute must for Fnatic. And if they can make it there, they can still win. But I think if they get less than 6 rounds on the T side, I'm actually going to not believe it any longer. Titan moving around a little bit more than I'd like to see. They're looking a little bit anxious here, just rotating around.
I don't like this at all. I really don't. I don't think it needs to be done. As I say that, what do I know? A great shot from Kenny S there. Krim's going to be taking down a key player on the Fnatic lineup. And looks like Kenny S will do more damage here. He takes down Flusher as well.
This kind of movement is really scary. He goes for his third one. In fact, he's already got the double looking for it. It's existence covering him with the auto sniper. Kenny, and it's a quad kill coming out.
Good.
All of them really sick shots. And now Titan are fired up. And in one round here that Fnatic really just could not lose. You said they could buy in. They are going to force it up once again. It won't be the most impressive buy here. So actually, if they fail this one, we could be looking at an 11-4 scoreline for the first half of this map.
As a CT, that is an absolutely amazing scoreline. So I think they're going to be very happy with that. And that is why Titan opt to play CT first. Most teams will say the T is a T-bias map and always take T. But Titan have such a strong CT setup. But here we go. Flusher actually opening the fragging up to Smith there.
Yeah, nicely done. Right again, it's going to be MBK coming in with a straight return. Now they're going to be rushing at the middle, and Scream is in this corner. He has heard them. He's calling for backup again, and he's going to go down. This time it doesn't work out. And Kenny in the CT spawn, missing the shot. Crims is going to instantly retaliate with that one, and it's going to be existence and MBK left. There's a 15th round, so they have to go for it. There's no saving any longer, and it's a 2-on-3 now as MBK is going to pick up that kill. But Fnatic, they must be able to hold down this bomb site.
Yeah, I think that this is their round. It's going to be very difficult indeed for existence to retake with an auto sniper in hand. I think his next kill might decide if MBK can find some form here. We might be able to. There it is, Pronax. I think that might decide the round now. If Existence manages to do that,
very smart.
Yeah, good stuff from him. So there we go, 10-5 in favor of Titan. Fnatic managing to pick up that last round, and I think they definitely needed it. I think this pistol is going to be absolutely vital for them if they're going to have any chance of. Getting 11 rounds on the CT side.
You could see Olofmeister shaking his head there, not being happy with his own performance either. I mean, he's such a strong player, and we saw this earlier, of course. So it's, we have actual evidence that he's that good, but it just it wasn't enough for the first half here. We'll see if they can pick it up. If Fnatic win the pistol round, make me make it 10-8, and then win the fourth round, they actually have a shot of still doing this, but it definitely will not be easy. So if you are just joining us, you're right on time to catch the rest of this tournament. This is the third map, second half, semi-finals between Titan and Fnatic. Still coming up is the other semi-final between virtus.pro and Dignitas, and then of course the grand finals. It's all today. So welcome to the Gfinity Global Offensive stream. Really happy to have you, and a big welcome to any new viewers that are coming in as well. Here we go, Henry. This pistol round, they have the setup for it, and they have a stack down towards the
I
middle.
I like that stack. It's a classic kind of 1.6 little setup there. It's good to see that coming back into the game. Always was very effective back in my day. Let's see what it can do here. JW would be the man on top looking for any kills he can get. I don't think the terrorists will suspect this. They're going to kind of make their way up to shore now, and here we go. He actually gets flashed, and there's terrorists in front of him everywhere. He's going to get taken down. His teammate's actually going to go down, and Olofmeister left to pick up the
good
pieces.
Headshot from Olofmeister, but they need it more. This bomb is going to go down, and they're going to try and retake with... They have a kit on Crims, and where is he going right now? This is actually important. He's going down on long, so if he dies and the kit is lost somewhere, that's going to be an issue. NBK, no issue at all. Taking down JW, gets time to reload, and it's going to be a double. God. It's going to be a triple NBK! The headshot's in return, and Titan are going to pick up the round. And Fnatic, they just had the door slammed right in their face.
Absolutely. Great work from NBK. I think he's had a fantastic tournament so far. He seems to be nothing getting past him like he... So many rounds of flurries of kills from him. So yeah, fantastic work, and that's a very, very important pistol round indeed. And we can see this scout coming out again for CT. Maybe I've missed something in CSGO, but it seems this tournament a lot of people are opting for and kind of seeing what they can do with it. Olofmeister perhaps trying to redeem himself by getting his team back into the game with a huge play with a scout.
Whenever I see this online, I always just say to myself, well, it's an online best of one game. They are probably just, you know, they're hoping for the very best and they're not taking it as seriously as they should be, but I don't know, maybe Fnatic are thinking, you know, jumping headshot from somebody, maybe that's going to be it. I mean, it's Olofmeister who's picked it up, so maybe it's also just him on a sort of personal level
saying,
yeah,
personal little vendetta here to kind of show he is still on the server and he can do some damage. Let's see what he can do here. He's going to be given an opportunity, fluffs his lines a little bit there, not able to make the shot, and this is it. The terrorists will be able to make their way up to shore now, and unless he hits the next shot, I don't think he'll be able to do much with the scout. There it is, that's the missed shot there. Oh, yeah, not going to be able to do much with that.
No, Pronax up on short here, right behind the smoke. They're going to flash their way through. Pronax turns around in a good time, but 5-7 versus AK is not really a fair fight at this point in the game. And before Fnatic can actually buy here, we're going to be at 13-5, and that's just not a comfortable situation. The bomb is going to be planted here. Some good kills coming in from Crimson JW, and it actually puts it back into a 3-on-3. If they can somehow retake this and win the round, that would be absolutely huge right now. They need everything they can get, but they're not going to go for it. They're going to save the rifles and look to see if they can win next time. Do you agree with this?
I think that's, to be fair, like the saving kills, I'm not sure how effective they're going to be. But with no kits in hand, I think that retake was always going to be very difficult indeed. I think saving the guns next round is obviously going to help them out, and potentially they want to string rounds together and get their economy back on track. So throwing those away perhaps wouldn't have been in their best interest.
Oh, NBK shot in the toes, and I think this bomb is going to take it with him. So Olofmeister, at least by proxy, ended up killing him, and that's something. Not going to count on the scoreboard, unfortunately, which is very sad.
But we know.
We know. We've witnessed it, so don't worry. 12-5, and moving into the 18th round, let's see if the rest of Fnatic can step it up here and really grind some rounds home. They're actually going to force it up in this round, and I don't even know. I mean, at this point...
I think they're all in right now. I think they know that they're on the harder side, and they really need to do something special to get back into it. Like, you can tell that the morale might be quite low here. Galils, Famuses, Scouts. It's not the buy I'd like on the CT half when you're already up against it with against the terrorist side. We can see they've got a few grenades to hand, but not nearly enough to kind of hold the choke points off of as long as they'd like.
Maybe not quite enough. Olofmeister jumping just like they were doing on the other side, trying to see if he can look over that smoke in the middle and maybe pick up a kill on somebody. But in the meantime, the rest of Titan are taking control of mid slowly but surely, and the smoke is still helping them out. Olofmeister's really trying to put some effort into it. It's just not easy finding an opening. An absolutely pristine grenade going to take screen down to 21 points of health. And now Pronax up on short with the FAMAS in hand, does a little bit of damage but also spots them out. They are going to be pushing. Pronax, this is not the ideal weapon to fight at this range with, and he's up against AKs. Good smoke's going on right now. Pronax going to be up on the box, trying to see if he can shoot through somewhere, and they haven't spotted him out. He's going to be right here, takes the one, and that's not going to be enough. Kenny will take down Pronax. Olofmeister's dropped by Scream, and now maybe a bomb plant's coming up. Flusher with a really good headshot. Existence still up here by Goose, and he's going to go down. Flusher with an amazing throw coming out here, but Kenny will finish it off. Instantaneous double headshot, and that will be it. Penny gets a high five all the way down. Scream enjoying those headshots, and that's going to be now Fnatic even deeper in the hole.
Yeah, fantastic work from Kenny Esther, showing he's just as effective an AK as he is of an AWP. Fantastic little one balls there. And yeah, that's going to just send another message home to Fnatic that they really have got their work cut out against them. Titan are firing on all cylinders right now, and it's going to take a lot to get back into this game for Fnatic. It feels like they might almost be done. I think they've probably got one more gun round in them to kind of pull this back, but it's just slipping it further and further away. As I say, that Pronax actually manages to get a kill onto Existence, and that's going to knock Titan back onto the back foot a little bit.
Yeah, careful. A little bit of a shame he couldn't pick up the rifle from the kill. That's obviously a big difference, and anything Fnatic can get at this point is going to be helping them try and see if they can get back into the game somehow, get back on their feet. But they're still dizzy from the whole chain series of knockout blows they've been receiving, and they haven't really recovered, not even close right now. MBK gets peeked on down here and actually goes down very low, so it's a good peek from JW. If he could got that kill, it would have been something.
Time ticking away. This is nice from Titan. They don't need to commit to anything. Use your time effectively and see what you can do. MBK showing why you do it, because you can just wait for the CT to make the mistake and then you take precedence on the map.
Yeah, and now up inside the A bomb site is Olofmeister waiting down there. Maybe he can pick up a couple of more kills here. C said he's going to get a chance for it any second now. Peeks out and he reveals himself, so that's not good, but still a great headshot comes in. Five bullets more, instantaneous headshot on Kenny. Yes, so very nicely done here. Olofmeister coming a little bit back into the game. It's going to be Crims taking the last kill on screen. It's very, 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 very late in the hour here for Olofmeister to start stepping it up, but if he could, I mean,
it's going to take a hell of a performance to get him back into this, but never say never. There's no reason why they can't do exactly what Titan did to them on this half. It looks like we might see an almost force buy here from Titan.
Yeah, and actually, I mean,
I don't like when people do this. I don't think it's justified when you've got so many rounds in the bank. I think this is why people do make comebacks, just because you kind of ruin your economy like this. But as we've seen it happen so many times before, when you've got a player like Kenny S on your side, he can make anything happen. So I guess that's what they're opting for. Just in my opinion, it's not worth the investment right now.
No, I'm going to side with you on this one as well. I really don't think it's a good idea. And I guess if everyone else on Titan could have bought armor and forced it up and they were just trying to equalize their economy like that, maybe there's a reason for it. But
it's not needed right now. I think that we've got so many rounds on the board. Like, just close this out. Like, do it properly. Don't try and do it in style and get the moments everyone's going to be talking about for years. Just close this game out and take yourself into the next stage of the tournament.
Yeah, because this can, you're absolutely right. I mean, we're talking about 10 rounds more or less in a row here for Fnatic. They really can't afford to give anyone away, but that's definitely doable, and especially if Titan kind of get into the mentality that we've almost always already won this, you know, we're just on the edge, just a few more rounds and we're home safe.
Sure.
Can't think like that.
That AWP now is going to be given away. The Fnatic know it's on the map somewhere, and they'll probably take a step back here and force them to kind of overface it to get any forward picks. It would be silly if they had someone window here, as they know it's going to... Oh, God, as you say that, Olofmeister runs around the corner, flush, having a frag of his own. And Olofmeister seems to be waking up here and actually starting to get on the frag charts a little bit more.
Yeah, double kill for him. Definitely not bad. He's been almost quadrupling, I think, his score in the last couple of rounds here. Scream alone, and they already know he's there, banging right through. It's going to be JW picking up the last kill, and we're looking at a 7-13 scoreline and a 6-round difference between the two teams. And on Titan's side,
they're forcing another kind of shaky buy here. This is what we're talking about. Once you lost that all buy, you're kind of setting yourself up for another horrible one. And this could be, this is where it gets frustrating. Like, for me, especially if I was leading this team, I'd just say, right, we've got enough rounds to take it. Let's take a couple of ecos, get the economy back on track, and then we'll just win out. We'll do what we have to do then. I feel like this might be another round thrown away just because they haven't really got the weapons in their inventory to kind of take this on.
I mean, they have smokes, but really critically, I think MBK has no armor at all, which means, you know, one chest shot from one of those M4s, and that's going to be that aim duel lost instantly. They do have the smokes to make something work, and they are setting up across the map right now. Fnatic, are they going to have the position for it? I'm not sure if this is the best position they could have for what looks like it's going to be a bit of a split towards that B bomb site, maybe. A good flashbang comes in. This is going to have to be huge. Flusher can't go down. Pronax flashed. Flusher's dead inside the bomb site. Crim's doing a lot of work. Going to pick up the one kill. He's being wrapped around here, but he's still staying alive somehow. He picks up another one. A great double kill from Crim's, and that leaves Scream alone in a 1-on-4 that looked like it was going to be such an opening from Titan. Looked like they had that on lockdown, but Fnatic quick with the rotate, pick up the kill, and we're seeing it now.
Please, Eco Titan, take some time and just win it properly. If you want to close this out, do it correctly. That's two rounds I think we've seen them almost throw away now. I'd like to see them just kind of take the full eco now and kind of just wait your
time. Yeah, bear this in mind. Do Fnatic ever get back to a point where we're looking at a 13-13 or 13-14 scoreline, something like that? And then try and see if you're, just trying to imagine asking Titan if they would have liked to have had another couple of rounds to play around with. And definitely the answer would be yes. This is actually still very scary. Fnatic, I mean, just like they did on Inferno, they're showing us here that they are a resilient team. They really don't give up easily.
Well, just a note, I think we can see existence with the bomb and T-Spawn. I think he's either AFK or he might have had a crashed out there.
No, this is very classic Titan, I think.
Oh, is he kind of having a big team talk right now?
I'm almost wondering if we could get the actual camera on them. It's almost like it'd be worth it for us just to switch for a second, because that is something we see Titan do quite a bit.
I don't know if the crowd can see, is he walking up and down right now? Someone says that was going on. Yeah. Kind of guy trying to pump everyone up.
I think they're definitely discussing how that next round is going to be happening.
Well, I think he's been a little bit silly here with the last couple of rounds. I think he might be feeling the pressure a little bit and wanting to close this out. We know it's a big game and there's a lot of pressure, but I still think you can't let that cloud your judgment. You need to do this properly and do it with a little bit of a method instead of trying to do the big stylish finishes.
Well, 30 seconds left and Pronax is not going to go down here. There's going to be a plant for Scream, which in itself is actually very helpful, but in a 1-on-3, probably not going to be able to win this round. The rotation is already in effect and he doesn't have any equipment to deal with it. Just 12 bullets here in the C set and he's going to go down. Still a bit scary. I mean, they're going to pick up the AWP here for JW, and I think Fnatic have enough money as well to work with in general. Not an astounding amount, but they have some money to work with. It's going to be 13-9 and now Titan have...
They have the
a whole lot.
Here we go. This is the round they should close it out with. They've felt out the CTs. They've seen how the setups are. If I was a CT now, though, this is the round I would be doing something a little bit more audacious and kind of getting in the face of the T's, because I know they're going to be adapting and trying to do anything they can to get this round and trying to adapt to what I'm doing. So I wouldn't be surprised if we saw the CTs doing something a little bit special this round.
Well, JW has the AWP. NBK is running for long, looking for the pickoff, and he's going to miss it by just an inch. Double grenade in return. Brings him down a little bit, but not a devastating amount of damage. He's going to be able to recover somehow if he can just pick up the right angle here. And in the middle, they have JW waiting with that AWP. Kenny's going to be up towards short, and instant flash comes in. We'll see. What's the opening going to be? It looks like they are actually trying to adjust here, Fnatic.
Here we go. I think Scream's going to make the better of him. Yeah, there it is. Crims gets taken down at the hand of that brutal aim with Scream.
And JW misses the shot. Scream anticipating there's going to be one more there. Are they going to go for the biddy split? It looks like they're coming out the middle as well. Existence picks up the kill, and JW is about to be in an absolute world of trouble. He's up in the window. He's going to peek in, misses the shot, but they know he's there. And we're talking about a 5-on-3 retake here, and now a 5-on-2, and the rest of Fnatic are going to have to pack up their gear and run somewhere else. This is a 14-9 scoreline. Fnatic, I mean, they were in the middle of this comeback.
Yeah, well, I think they were kind of giving it, to be honest. Like, we saw those, like, we keep bringing up those last two silly rounds, but I think like, this is all Titan had to do. They're outplaying individually, they're outplaying Titan right now, and I think, they're outplaying Fnatic, and I think all they needed to do was wait for the CTs to make the mistakes. We saw Scream just holding patiently in the upper B tunnels, was gifted a kill there, and that completely opened the round up. And they didn't need to do anything too special or open them out of the self. It's kind of given to them. So that's great to see from Titan. They're going to kind of hopefully close this one out now, I think. I think that's going to be real devastating for Fnatic. And I think this might be the time to close this one out now.
Yeah, all of a sudden, the pressure really triples. And actually, Titan are going to pick up two orbs. One of them, I think, Smith's because of the spawn position.
We can see that spawn. This normally does work so well for people. Like, this is one of the spawns I love taking as well. If you can get this with an orb and you can get the nice jump there, bide you a couple more milliseconds, I think he might be onto something here if he can just land the shot. Oh, as we say that, JW smashes him in the face, and Smith has gone down at the hand of JW. Great stuff from him.
Yeah, great minds think alike, apparently, and JW on the other end thought, well, I have just the same idea. I'm going to go for it here, and they had three people down on long, so a really good start for Fnatic. See if they can prevent this this match point coming in from Titan. Smoke is going to go up any second, but Olofmeister has the right timing, going to walk right through and take down Scream. No coverage at all. Existence running for the return, and not going to get it. Instant grenade comes out and takes him down to about 80 points here. Now it's going to be Flusher on the other side. And Titan now in a 5-on-3. And this comeback from Fnatic is apparently not going to be stopped so easily.
Absolutely not.
We'll see. The Swedes, they have the five rifles on their side. And in the meantime, Titan making their move. The bomb is actually dropped behind right now. And that's definitely not how smokes work. So. BK looking through. He actually spots that and crims. Oh, he goes down to Kenny. Now it's a 3-on-3 inside this bomb site. Fosha has to stay installed. He must stay alive. If he goes down, that is going to be a huge waste here. Fnatic, they got to stay strong down the middle as well. And BK picks up a kill on JW. It's AWP versus AK, or sorry, versus M4 in the middle. And Flusher, again, just hiding inside here. 15 seconds left, and Titan are making their final push into the bomb site. They spotted Flusher now, and he's going to go down. Pro next. 10 seconds left. You can just kill the bomb planter here. It's going to be already peaks in. There's the one kill. 7 seconds, 6 seconds, and there's going to be a straight defuse coming in here. No Pro next. He's going to peek right there. And there's enough time. He's going to run away. Pro next will win the round. Good and Existence, no time left. A great kill coming through, and Pronex will even finish off Existence after the time is out. That's a huge blow to Titan's confidence.
Yeah, I think that round was already Fnatic's kind of tied up. I think it was quite lucky for Titan to get back into that. Like, after they missed that smoke on CT spawn, it seemed like he almost kind of helped them out. It kind of gave them the opportunity to kill Crims at CT spawn. But yeah, you can't take anything away from Crims there. From Pronax, absolutely fantastic clutch from him there. Nice patient play and managed to stop the plant.
And potentially a little bit confusing. I mean, I guess they thought he was coming from Upper Dark, in fact, when he was in the window. So it's a little bit of a shame they didn't have that information.
I guess it was a poor position to be in anyway. Never really want to stand in the open in that kind of situation. But that's going to be a very important round indeed. That's going to knock the confidence of Titan. They're going to start getting a little bit frustrated now. It looked like 14-10. It's like not as comfortable as it once looked.
No, and they forced up once again just to bring this point back again. Yeah. I mean, Kenny did get an instant shot through the door on Crims, but again, maybe not the ideal scenario.
I think these forced buys are a little bit silly in my opinion, but they really just want to close it out. And I think they're just going to rely on Kenny S and that big AWP of his to kind of open the round up for them and hopefully get them onto match point. But it's going to take a lot of work, time dwindling away here as they kind of hold up. It doesn't seem like there's not many grenades or smoke grenades in hand, so they're going to have to do some serious work here, and it looks like they might be just kind of pincering CT spawn, and as they do that, they're not going to be able to find much going on, and Olaf Meister takes down Scream, and this has gone all sorts of wrong for Titan right now.
Yeah, well, they know there's one guy in the corner that's pretty valuable information here. Kenny looking for the kill, he misses it, and what a strange round coming out from Titan. I'm sure Scream's going to have that kill. Kenny's going to get hunted down, and it's 14-11, and now they're going to have to eco, which means Fnatic are going to be within striking distance at this point, and everybody's waking up, including Olaf Meister right now. Fnatic are on the verge of something really great here, and you've got to give them some credit. No matter how this finishes, both teams have had a really interesting tournament, and at the end, I think they're showing us both what they're really worth.
Yeah, great spirit from Fnatic here. They're showing that even when they were so far down, they haven't given up, and they've got themselves right back in this, and it's looking like it's going to be a 14-12 score. Like, we see Existence taking his AFK stature again. I'm not really sure what that's about. Is that... You told me that's a thing he normally does.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure if we can get the camera on them, and if we were over there looking, I'm sure we would see Existence just talking to his teammates right now and discussing the upcoming round. And I mean, if they can come up with even one plan, one genius move to make it work, that'll be enough.
It's not even genius moves. It's just stop making stupid ones. Like stop forcing these buys. In my opinion, like they had so many rounds to play with. And that's not being me bad manager or anything like that. I'm just saying that the moves haven't been the smartest one, in my opinion. They're trying to close it out when it's not ready for it. They kind of need to just wait and kind of bide their time.
What kind of strategy would you go for coming into this? I mean, they've tried for the B-split push a couple of times, and it feels like it's just on the verge all the time of working. So would you keep pushing that angle?
Yeah, I just wait till you have the full bite, and then at least you can say, oh, okay, well, at least we lost it in a full situation now. We didn't have two CZs and an AWP. I think that's what it's coming down to. It's coming down to a lot of close rounds. We've seen the clutches being brought into play. They lost a 2-on-1 situation. But I think what they're doing is that's not the problem. It's the equipment they're taking to the round.
They really want to get a bomb plant this round, actually, and they invested a little bit into it. And it's actually going to happen as well for Existence. So this is a great move coming out from Titan. Doesn't matter that they all die now. Just the fact that they get the bomb down is the only crucial thing here. And Scream trying to land another headshot in, but he's actually running out of bullets outright. But bomb plant, very, very important here for Titan. And we're looking at a 14-12 scoreline, only a 2-round difference. The gap has completely shrunk, almost non-existent at this point.
Yeah.
And Titan are feeling the pressure, probably a lot more than Fnatic are.
Yeah, all of a sudden when they're having fun with three sniper rifles, those days have long gone. And now it looks like they're going to have a little bit of sweat on their brow, perhaps. And they actually opt for no AWP whatsoever. They've gone for a 5 AK setup, a change of tactics here. And they can see what they can do. JW missing that opening shot.
And if Smith's going hyper-aggressive here, takes the battle, but he doesn't realize there's one guy by car, and nice. Smith is going to come up big here. The kill on Pronex and the rest of the Titan Jason putting on the pressure. Olofmeister caught up, but MBK missing crucial shots. Kenny won't. He's going to take down Olofmeister, and now the take is on. Henry, the answer was even more pressure, even more aggressiveness coming out here from Titan.
Yeah, good stuff from them. Good kills. Classic A split, the smoking off middle, getting up those choke points as fast as they can. The Smiths on that great opening kill on long there. That really did open up the round and started pulling the CTs apart. As soon as he got that opening frag, it enabled the guys to come up short, and it just really did open the round up for them. Traditional CS there, nothing too fancy, but it really worked, and they're just relying on their pure aim and talent there to get them back into it.
And I'm guessing Fnatic have enough money to go for this retake either way. They're going to be able to buy, and they won't be saving after this anyway, so this is why they're going for it in a 3-on-5. Smoke us up, and if they can try for a defuse, it'd be absolutely amazing, but there's so many Titan players on this bomb side, and it is not working out. Kenny with the double before he goes down, and it's going to be JW trying to take some exit kills here, running away from the explosion. That's almost the whole of the Titan. Well, actually, they could have all died then, but they just stay alive. 15-12. Yep. Match, map point here.
Here we go.
Titan, a single round away from moving to the grand finals here at Gfinity.
Absolutely. This is obviously a huge round here. And we, as you said, Fnatic have got enough money to kind of get themselves back into this. It's not over yet. Three rounds to go. They've strung that together already on the CT side. It's going to have to dig deep here and go for something a bit, little bit different, perhaps. But with no AWP on the hands of terrorists, it could allow JW to kind of open this round up, perhaps. You can see him kind of holding that long area now. Not going to have much in terms of opposition straight away.
Could anything at this point be better than an overtime? I'm not sure. That'd be a really...
It would be great.
Almost too much to handle, I feel like.
A fantastic story.
I'm not even in this game, but I can feel the you know, in my fingers. You feel it too? Just a little bit of...
mounting excitement.
Exactly. Flashbang comes in, Pronex can't see a thing, and he's trying to fall backward. Actually, they're not going to push him here. Could have been an opening, and in the middle, it's going to be JW Flusher and Pronex picking up a ton of kills, and Flusher's going to come in, take the challenge. Kenny with a quick double and scream with one, and now what is going on? Fnatic, did they just throw this away? If they check this corner, Crims is going to be right here waiting in the middle, I think, running up. I think they must have heard him. They know there's one guy down by lower. Olofmeister's giving this game a little bit away here. If they get the kill on him, then they're going to rotate back for sure.
God, got a cat and mouse here. No one really knows where each other are. The next frag, I think, is going to tie this game up.
It could very
one way or another.
Are they going to realize that Olofmeister moved back? Kenny goes down. The bomb is given up, and that's our huge tail. Now the rotation coming in from Crims as well. Scream, what is he going to do here? He picks up the bomb, but 20-second Scream. You can't do this. You're going to have to commit to this one. Running right through. Oh. Olof goes down, and we are in our one-on-one, and here it comes. Now is where the game gets very close. Molotov to close it up here. Crims is going to try and sneak some other path here. The bomb is down. Scream with the double. Crims has the weight of the world on his shoulders. This is the difference between being knocked out in the quarters, or sorry, in the semis, and going on to the grand finals. And it's long-range Scream! Picks up the headshot. That's the triple. And GG has been called, and Titan, they make their way through after failing for such a long time. Now is the time for them to be in the finals of a very big tournament indeed. And look at them right here. I'm not sure if
a sigh of relief, maybe, if anything.
They look almost catatonic. I think they're not really, it hasn't dawned on them yet, Henry. What is going on?
Oh, look, yeah, I can see MBK there. Kind of just a big sigh of relief. I think they made that a lot harder for themselves than they had to. Almost a few silly rounds there, but ultimately the result that it should have been.
What an absolutely incredible end. A one-on-one like that.
That was great.